If you've run out of storage space in the basement, attic, or garage, a self-storage unit can be a good solution. But before you store your stuff, Susan Hogan has a warning. Good morning.
Good morning, Will.
This seems like it's a pretty easy thing. You have stuff.
Yeah.
You need a place to put it.
Yes.
You go put it in that place.
Yes.
You lock it up, and then trouble?
Well, yeah, I know. In a perfect world, nothing would happen, right? You think it's just so easy.
Yeah.
But unfortunately, it's not a perfect world, and things do definitely happen. Without a doubt.
What are some of the things we need to look for? I mean, you know, if you're storing expensive stuff, I mean, you want a place that's secure.
Absolutely. Well, you know, the thing is, this story came about because it's one of our top 10 most complained about things that people have issues with. And not just that, the Better Business Bureau was also telling us they received over 1,000 complaints just last year alone from people in regards to storage complaints, whether they couldn't get access to their stuff when they needed it, their things were stolen or damaged when the unit was locked up. So, you know, there's a lot of things going on here and people just don't know, you know, what's going on. Bottom line is, when you're looking for a storage unit, it should be just like whether you're shopping for a car or any large ticket item, because it's not like you're just paying $125 for 1 month. This is consecutive months, usually.
Right.
It could be for years. So it's a large ticket item. You want to go and actually look at 3 different storage facilities and really go and visit them. Are they clean? Are they climate controlled? If you're storing things that need air conditioning or heat.
Mm-hmm.
And also, how secure are they? Look around to make sure that there are actually security cameras there that you know that your stuff is being secured.
What are some of the things you can do? I mean, if you do store store stuff and then you have a problem afterwards, where do you go?
Well, yeah, I know, exactly. A couple of things, first of all, before you even get into that situation, you want to do some things like, what's the cost? You know, again, visiting those 3 facilities, you'll see whether or not you're paying too much for one particular one. When you're looking at the cost factor, sometimes the base price that they give you might say $100 or $90 or $80 a month. But what you want to ask them there is, what else is there anything added on?
Right.
Electricity, pest control, sometimes storage facilities will add those onto your bill and you're part of their monthly utility.
Because you don't want any stuff that's in there getting ruined by any rodents or anything
exactly.
else that may be around.
Right, so you need to find out about the cost, first of all. Second thing is the size. There are so many different size units. When you're bringing your stuff into storage, you want to ask them, can I pile my boxes up to the top of the ceiling? A lot of storage facilities will not let you really pack things in there. That's going to make a difference when you're paying for the particular storage unit. Ask them what about also weight of your things as well. So aside from size, you also want to ask about climate, as I had mentioned before. If whatever you're storing requires, sometimes people store furs or other, you know, antique furniture that you don't want to have, you know, in the freezing cold or in the heat of the summer. Are these storage facilities air conditioned? Are they heated if you need to have that done?
Right.
Also ask about insurance. If you have a home and you're storing things, sometimes your homeowner's insurance will already take care of that
for
you. So you don't need additional insurance. But if you do need insurance, I would highly recommend getting insurance for your stored goods. It's just as if you're renting an apartment.
Just a precaution.
It's just a precaution. If the storage facility offers you insurance, again, shop around. Look for other third-party insurance companies as well. And safety, again, check to make sure that there are security cameras. They also have, a lot of them have codes that you get or I would get if we have storage things in there.
Right.
That's a really great, I like that. That means you can't even walk into that facility without plugging in a code. Your code is unique to just you, so they know who's coming and who's going at all times.
Now, what if they ask you, I mean, you obviously know better than I, but do they ask you what you're storing, and do you tell them what you're storing?
They can ask you, but on your contract, it will specifically say you're not allowed to store, you know, firearms, explosives,
right.
different things like that. And they, you know, you sign that contract, and you know, if you are, and something happens,
it's your responsibility. Yeah.
One other quick thing I want to mention to you as well: if you forget to pay or you can't pay your monthly fee, a lot of times people will tell me that, well, you know what, my stuff is up for auction.
Oh.
Well, you know what, if you looked in your contract, it's there in black and white.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, after so many months, a storage facility, and they will tell you, they'll give you warnings, they're not going to just put your stuff up for auction. They will give you warnings, and after so many times, you're not paying your storage unit, guess what?
It's on
the auction block, like that wet storage wars.
I love that show.
Exactly.
I love it. All right.
That happens a lot.
Good stuff. All right.
Sure.
Thank you so much. Great advice. Thanks for coming in today. And if you want to read more about these, Susan's tips, you can head to WPRI.com.